Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Music session 12 with Charley.
Saturday, Sunday, too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days. Each day different and
sharks.
Every day new.
Welcome to another music session. It's music session number 12. What a big number. Okay, and I've got my special cards here again today. So should we start off with our treble clef? That's right, treble clef, treble clef. Well done. And then we have our dynamics, our louds and our quiets. Now let's just see if you remember. I'm going to mix them all up. Mix, 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 mix. Here we go. Quiet, that's right, quiet. And this one. Very loud. Good job. And this one. Loud, loud. Well done. And this one. Very quiet, very quiet. Well done. Shall we move on to our note counts? So can anybody clap this? One. Do it all together. One. Well done. Can we clap this one? One, two. Well done. Our two count note. Our two count note. Should we clap it again? One, two. Well done. And what about this one? Our four count note. Should we try clapping it? Are you ready? One, two, three, four. So remember to catch it and hold it and then nod your head on the other numbers. Ready? One, two, three, four. Well done. Now should we try muddling these up and see if you can remember them? Ready? Muddle, 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 muddle. Muddle, 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 muddle. Well done. Right, let's have a look. So, can we clap this? It's our two count note. Are you ready? One, two. Well done. And this one? One. Well done. Let's clap it all together. One. Good job. And this one. Our four count note. Let's clap it. Ready? One, two, three, four. Good job. Well done. Right. And then we've got our special notes, haven't we? What is the red note? Can anyone remember its name? It's C. C. That's right. C for cat. And this is what it sounds like. C, C. Well done. And can anybody remember what our orange note is called? Our orange note. That's right, D. D for dog. D, D. Well done. And we learned another one last time, didn't we? Can you remember what this is? It's at the start of elephant. E, 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 E for elephant. And this is what it sounds like. E, E. So there are notes so far. Now there's lots of notes, but we're going to learn something different today. Should we have a look in my bag and see what it is? Are we ready? Ooh. What is this? We haven't seen this before, have we? Now, it is only for one count, so it's the same as our one beat note, our one, one. It's the same as that, but this is silent. So in music, if you see one of these, it means shh for one beat. So you ready? Shh, one, okay? Shh. We just do one quick shush. Can you do that with me? Shh. Well done. So we've got one as a clap, one, and one as a rest. Shh. Can you say rest? Rest. Should we find out what else we have to do today?
Tiny talk.
Fish. Fish. Can you sign? Fish. Fish.
One, two, three, four, five.
One, two, three, four, five. Once I caught a fish alive. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Then I let it go again. Why did you let it go? Because it bit my finger so. Which finger did it bite? This little finger on my right.
Tiny talk.
Baby. Baby. Can you sign? Baby. Baby.
Baby shark.
Baby shark, do-do-do-do-do, baby shark, do-do-do-do-do, baby shark, do-do-do-do-do, baby shark. Mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark. Daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark. Grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandma shark.
Grandpa shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandpa shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandpa shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandpa shark.
Let's go hunt, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunt, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunt, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunt. Run away, do-do-do-do-do, run away, do-do-do-do-do, run away, do-do-do-do-do, run away. Safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last. It's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end!
Find a nice spot in your garden for today's special story.
Our special story today is Shark in the Park by Nick Sharratt. And what's that? That looks a little bit scary, doesn't it? Should we look inside?
Oh, I don't want to.
Oh my goodness, look, it's a shark. Ooh, should we read the story and find out what happens? Down at the park, a little boy is testing out his brand new toy. Look, there's ducks in the pond. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 ducks. And there's a cat. And butterfly. It's like a very pretty park. Timothy Pope is looking through his telescope. He looks up and down and left and right and all around. And this is what he sees. Oh no! What a nasty surprise. In his loudest voice, Timothy cries, "There's a shark in the park!" Oh dear. Oh, phew! A shark, fancy that, it's only a cat. Cat, meow. Well, that's good, isn't it? No shark yet. Right, Timothy Pope looks again through his telescope. He looks at the sky, he looks at the ground, he looks left and right and all around. And this is what he sees. Oh no! What a terrible sight. Timothy yells with all his might, "There's a shark in the park!"
Oh, I don't want to look.
Oh, phew. A shark, oh no, it's just a crow. Thank goodness for that. Timothy Pope looks once more through his telescope. He looks at the sky, he looks at the ground, he looks left and right and all around. And this is what he sees. Tim's not in any doubt. What do you think he's about to shout? "There's a shark in the park!" I think it might be a shark this time. Ooh. A shark? No, it's not. And aren't you glad? As a matter of fact, it's Timothy's dad. Time to go home, Timothy. Oh, they've got to go and leave the park. Timothy Pope says it's safe to say there are no sharks in the park today. But what's that in the duck pond? Ooh! I think that might be a shark. And look, the ducks are going quack. Oh dear. I wonder what happens next. I have to wait and see. My favourite part of the story when it turned out to be a cat, because I have a black cat and she gets in lots of trouble.
Time to get active and go on a hunt. It's baby shark.
We're going to start off low because we're going to be a baby shark. Bigger for mummy. And all the way
study. Take steps sideways and back the other way. And run! And really pull your arm down. Jazz hands and big marches.
Hi everyone, I've got a special instrument with me today. I've got some jars. Now, are jars instruments? I don't know if they are, but everything can be turned into an instrument. So, for example, if I bang these jars, they'll make a sound. Ready? Listen. It's a nice ting, ting, ting sound, isn't it? Now, if I run this along the side of the jars, have a listen. So they all make sounds. You can turn most things into instruments. And I've got some coloured water here. And I'm going to put a different amount of water in the jars. Do you think this will change what the jars sound like? Should we find out? So I'm going to pour some water into each of these jars. A little bit in this one. Half in this one. A lot in this one. And then I'm going to keep one empty. Okay, so have a listen. I'm going to put the empty one to the end. Have a listen to the change in sound. Listen again. Does it get higher or lower? Have a listen. This one's a lot lower, isn't it? Have a listen. Low, low, low. High, high, high. Okay, now if I run this along the side from low to high, it makes a nice sound. Now, what do you think would happen if I put the same amount of water in two jars? Should we find out? I'll put the same amount of water in. Let's have a listen now. I think that's pretty much the same, and look, there's pretty much the same amount of water in both. So you can change jars and the sounds they make by adding and taking away water, which is really cool. So if you've got any empty jars at home, try filling them up with different amounts of water to make music. And I like to colour my water so I can see, because it looks really cool if it's coloured. And also, you don't have to use a proper stick. You can just use anything you find. So you can use a wooden spoon or a stick from the garden just to tap on the jars. But I do advise you to do it outside because it can get a bit messy. So that is our special instrument for the day, and I'm gonna play you away.
See you next time.